Hello, everyone. I'm Marco Slot. I'm a principal engineer on the Citus team at Microsoft, and I'm going to show you some of the cool things you can do with Hyperscale Citus. Imagine you have an application that generates a really large number of events. For example, GitHub publishes every event that happens on a public repo as a large JSON object via their API. Now, what if you want to take that huge stream of data and create an analytics dashboard that gets updated in real time, responds very quickly to queries, and can handle many concurrent users? Finding a database that can do all those things at scale is challenging. If I were building an application like this, I would probably use Postgres because it's so versatile. But when I get to more than a few hundred gigabytes of data, and my GitHub data is actually several terabytes large, my dashboard will start getting slow, far behind, and even if I pick the biggest Postgres node available. If I built my app using Azure Database for Postgres, then starting today, I'm no longer limited to a single node because I can use the new Hyperscale Citus option to scale out to as many as hundreds of nodes. Here, I created a database cluster with 10 nodes with a total of 320 cores and 2.5 terabytes of memory. Now, to set up my schema, I can use any Postgres tool. Here, I'm using Azure Data Studio. And I create an events table with a JSON column for my raw JSON data. And to distribute my Postgres table across all 10 nodes, I use the Citus function called create distributed table. Now, I don't want my application to interact with these bulky JSON objects directly. Instead, I want my application to have a table like GitHub commits, where I have a repo name and an author name and a message for every commit. I'm also going to extract a number of commits per day for every repository to render the charts in my dashboard. Now, to go from the raw event data to these more structured tables, I'm going to do a transformation inside my database. I created a function called extractCommits, which takes the newest push events from the GitHub events table, extracts the commits from the push events, and inserts them into my GitHub commits table. And then I also update the daily GitHub commits table. And because I'm using Hyperscale Citus, this transformation actually runs in parallel across all of my hundreds of cores, and it runs as one big distributed transaction. Now, I'm actually ingesting data and running the transformation right now in the background. So far, I have over 2 terabytes of data in my database. And you know, I can run queries against it, for example, the number of commits for the last 30 days for one of the repositories. And in the background, I'm actually replaying the entire GitHub history, which is several terabytes of data. Now let's have a look at all the things going on concurrently on my database cluster. In the top left, you see my data ingestion, streaming about 1 gigabyte of data into the database every few seconds. That's around 7 million events per minute, and each event is about 3 kilobytes in size. In the top right, you can see the extract commit function running in a loop, transforming and processing all the incoming events. And in the bottom right, I'm actually running a benchmarking tool that's generating over 50,000 dashboard queries per second, as if there were thousands of users querying the dashboard at the same time, and they see an average of 2 millisecond response time. Now, in addition to all these concurrent operations, I can also run low latency updates, even on a table with a billion rows, and I can scan the full table in under 2 seconds. No matter how big your data or how big your data stream, with Hyperscale Citus on Azure Database for Postgres, you can always provision enough CPU, memory, and disk to parallelize your workload across a scaled-out Postgres cluster and give your customers a level of performance you just can't imagine on a single Postgres node.